admin team. I've got 9 attack replays for you today, including some epic 10v10 action and an 11v11 triple bonus video for you guys. So let's get the hype flowing. First up, we've got Dr. Octagonpus smashing Nodge with a sweet TDH raid. TDH is a raid of pure skill that takes great patience to execute. So well done for executing this so smoothly. Absolutely beautiful raid. You start with a queen walk at 9 o'clock to clear trash. He drops a baby dragon to reinforce the queen direction towards 6 o'clock. He drops another baby dragon at around 7 o'clock to start clearing trash in that area. In just a moment, he drops some loons on the wizard tower to reinforce that queen direction towards 6 o'clock and takes out the enemy queen with his queen. The queen's now moving towards 6. The king is dropped at 6, reinforced with a wizard to start clearing the trash there, because he wants his queen to go inside the base. He tests a wall breaker. He sends reinforcement wall breakers to break in. In just a moment, the CC gets partially triggered by the king, so he has to deal with that. So he drops a poison down there. Queen getting raged through, poisons down for the rest of the CC, and he's planning on taking out another air defense as well, and the Tesla. At this point, he has used over half the allotted time, so he sends a hound in towards the air defense at 3 o'clock, followed up by some surgical loons to take out the defenses there, and then drops the minions straight away to clear off the trash building so that he doesn't time fail. He drops a few more surgical loons on the mortar, and notice he's still got 5 loons in the bag and 3 minions for cleanup, and he only has an archer tower and a wizard tower left that will actually hurt the raid. So he has swagged the hell out of this base. Absolutely great job. So much skill, so much patience it takes to execute that attack. And the thing with TDH is, it's a really slow-paced attack to begin with when the queen is walking, but the raid just absolutely explodes in the last half. It always looks like we're going to run out of time, but everything clears in less than a minute. Absolutely super OP, swagging up those spells. Great raid, absolutely well done to you. Next up, we have Reborn Britain hitting Elrond with a Queen of Shattered Hobo. Pulls the CC with a hog at the 12 o'clock air defense, but I just want to show you how well this one hog was actually placed. He drops the hog to go to this air defense. There's a mortar here and a mortar here that that hog could have just easily have gone to. So absolutely well done with the positioning of that hog. The entire raid probably. So well done there. Anyway, so he drops that hog. Drops the hog, pulls the CC. Queen goes down. behind. Early poison there. Delays a little bit on the rage, but gets the rage down nicely. CC gets taken out. Wiz goes down to reinforce the queen direction. He wants that to walk towards 9 o'clock. Golem's down on the 2 o'clock mortar and on the 7 o'clock mortar, and Wiz behind to build that funnel. Once the funnel is established, the king goes down, test wall breaker. Wall breaker's in to get the troops inside. Boulders go down, nice early jump placement, rages everything up. And look at this, look at how much value these boulders are gonna get. Just absolutely rips the base apart. Taken 80% of the base with the kill squad. He gets the enemy queen under a poison to slow her down, and then it's just hogs on the back end, under heel, deployed in like an Asian wall style deployment, and that's it. There's just one archer tower and two cannons left. Base is absolutely wrecked. Nothing left to stop it. There was just a troll tester in the corner that the hogs would deal with, and the rest is just clean up. Another great raid for the good guys. Well done, RB. Absolutely wrecked. Next on the agenda, we have one of our new players, one of the new guys to join WA. We've got Uh-Oh is destroying Icarus with a straight up shattered hobo. Now, I chose this attack because it's simple. Heroes down, bowlers down. gets delayed a little bit compared to the rest of the kill squad. That delays the queen entering the base. However, he waits for the hound to explode before he drops the poison, as the pups are more dangerous to the kill squad than the hound itself. So he's raged up the bowlers, they've taken out half the base, and then he sends in the hogs in a surgical spam style, and just places heals in potential places where bombs could be, just ripping the defences apart. Unfortunately, a giant bomb gave a lot of damage to most of his hogs, so what ended up being a 15 hog swag ended up with all the hogs dying, but it doesn't matter. There's just way too much left over, and only one tester. He's still got the queen ability. Uses that a bit early to get through the wall, but it's literally just trash left over. It was an absolutely great raid, so kudos to him. Hopefully we see more from him in the future. But absolutely great. Over. Base is wrapped. Next up, we have Pepe the Frog. Pepe the Frog hitting Mikey B. Hitting Mikey B with a stoned hobo variation, so it's not quite your traditional stoned hobo, slightly verified, but it is another OP strategy at Talcum. So he starts by dropping some loons to take out the mortar at 7 o'clock. Bottom goes down to 3. Don't know why he dropped the loon there, but he did. Wiz goes down to start building the funnel. Another golem at the 6 o'clock archer tower with wizards clearing off the trash at the corner. Corner trash. Third golem goes down and breaks in. King, queen go down, bowlers go down. Now, what I want to do is just pause there, because this is absolutely beautiful what we did here. What he does with the raid is he sections the base off, essentially. The kill squad go right, and the other side is dealt with by the hog. He literally just splits the base in half. It's absolutely beautiful what he does. And it's a great way to start thinking about freestyle planning for yourself. What I tend to do is split the base in half, or sometimes quarters, and I think to myself, how do I deal with this quarter, how do I deal with this quarter, how do I deal with this quarter, and how do I deal with this? Once you've figured a way to deal with all four quarters, you've got yourself a freestyle raid. So it's absolutely beautiful what he's done. He's split the base in half. It's given me a prime example of how to three-star plan attack for yourself. So thanks there, Pepe. Absolutely great. So we've got a nice early jump, nice early poison, rage goes down, and it's literally just wrecking a quarter of the base there. Sorry, I don't know what's up with my internet today. Jump goes down to control the path, and bowlers literally just wrecking that half of the base. And then he sends hogs in at 3 o'clock. Bear with me there. Absolutely great. He's got the hogs in at 3 o'clock. Now they're still targeting the cannon, and the arch tower is still targeting the golem. Now this is great because it essentially acts as an extra heal spell. So when you're deploying your hogs, if you deploy them next to defenses that are already targeting a golem or a king, it essentially acts as another heal spell because they're not taking any damage in that time. So it's absolutely great what he does there. And then he brings in more surgical hogs just for the last half of the base, and the base is absolutely wrecked. Nothing left to stop what's left over. Great job there, Pepe. Just cleaning up the last defenses there. Another TDH attack, so I'm not going to bore you with describing this attack. Just enjoy some tunes and watch a sick raid. Thank you. Ian have two 10v10 three stars. I have no choice in the matter. The raid kinda sucks. Two, a lot went wrong, but oh well, here goes nothing. So I start by dropping my king at 6 o'clock, followed by a minion on the corner trash building. I then drop my queen at 9, take corner trash, the mortar, and the air defense. I zap, as you've just seen, the 6 o'clock air defense. The king goes the wrong way, was supposed to head towards 3 o'clock, but I guess it kind of clears the trash out of the way for the dragons that are next to come. I dropped the loon too late. That was supposed to clear an air bomb by the cannon that the queen just killed. So yeah, lots have gone wrong. Dragons go down. Loon behind them for some reason. Hound goes down. Clone spell, and I drop a loon in the hole by the inferno, followed by some more surgical looms to back it up. And then I drop a hound at 12 o'clock, followed by some surgical looms to clear off the 12 o'clock air defences. So I've taken out most of the key air defences at this point. Looms are dropping left, right and centre. Only an inferno, an arch tower and a tesla left that can really touch my dragons that are left. The inferno goes down in just a second. Just as the last loon dies as well. And that's it, it's just dragons that will clear up the rest. And that's another 3 stars for the good guys. Starts the miners from 2 o'clock, know, into the base. Not very much left to actually hurt the miners. Ground skeletons pop up, so we deal with that by dropping a heal. Ground skeletons hurt fast miner attacks, but he's destroyed most of the base. He's about halfway, over halfway through now. Defense wise, so we just pass heals in the way of the miners at the wizard tower to stop the splash from hurting them. And he's got one heal left over, only point defense and an expo left, two expos left that will actually hurt the miners, but that's it. Base is absolutely wrecked, nothing left to actually hurt them. It was a close call, he almost time failed, but nah, absolutely great attack. Two 10v10s, which is absolutely great. So yeah, absolutely nice attack, well done, Happy. So that concludes CC with a baby dragon, but because of the archers it moves, so the baby dragon dies. So he has to kill the CC with his queen mort, so he drops the queen and a poison. Hound then explodes and he clears off a couple of pups with some minions. CC dealt with, a couple more minions go down, and then he rages and wall breaks to get the queen inside the base. Rages the queen again to keep her up so that he can concentrate on the kill squad. Bowler's just clearing off some trash under rage. Takes out the enemy queen. Bowler's kind of go one way and king goes the other, but not a problem. The funnel has been well established here. Takes out that last air defense as well. Trouble to the dragons, and then he's got a straight path to the town hall for his dragons. He's already got most of the percentage now, so he just freezes and rages those dragons. Absolutely nothing left to stop them, they just rip through the remainder, and that's a nice high 60 something percent 2-star. 10v11, absolutely great raid. Good start to Jay's career with us as well. Absolutely great. Love to see him in CWL. Can't really ask for much more from a 10v11 attacker. He ends at 64%, which under old meta was a good raid for 10v11. Under this new meta though, we're only seeing 50-something%, so 64% on 10v11 is absolutely great. Next, or last, should I say. We have number one, and that is J Storm versus One Dom Blonde. Another great attack. It has been a bit of a pain for our tens to get the two star on this base, even though we've seen it before. But we absolutely got there in the end for the 10B11 two star. So he drops a single loon to soak up some air mines. He drops some more loons to clear off an air defence and a cannon. Then he drops his queen at 9 o'clock with healers, so queen walking towards 12. Baby dragon down to clear off the trash in that area to build that side and get some free percentage. Rage down. Queen forcing her towards 12 o'clock. Actually had a few wall break fails as well, but it doesn't matter. He gets it in the end and clears off a good percentage of the base with his queen. So absolutely great walking there. Breaks in, queen clears off the mortar, I believe, and then goes inside the base and starts working her way down, then towards 3 o'clock. He then drops a golem at 2 o'clock in just a moment, followed with some backup bowlers to clear the trash. And the king will go down to help the effort as well, and that's coming in from 2 o'clock. Rage down, clears off all that trash. He's got a nice early jump in place as well. King breaking through the wall. Valks help the effort. And they've got nowhere to go to but into the Inferno compartment with the town hall. Rages them up, they go absolutely nuts inside there, take the town hall. That's the 50%. And there was great raid from J Storm hitting One Dom Bond. Great stuff. That concludes it for our potluck recap special. Be sure to subscribe to see new content and like this video. Don't forget to share with your friends. I'll leave you with an 11v11 three star and keep clashing, my friends. Thank you.